The race of life. Don't give up yet. Once upon a time, there were five friends who went for a race called the race of life. The race had three rules. One, everyone must take the finest racing car and use the path convenient to him or her. Two, anyone can be helped along the way. Three, the person who reaches the final destination first wins the race. The first two friends went to see their parents to help them buy the best racing cars to help them win. The second two friends went to hire the best racers to help them win. Nice. The last guy had no experience in driving or racing and did not have anybody to help him so bad. Soon the race began and the four friends took the lead and started battling and competing with each other as to who stays on top at first place. Who is the champ? Next. Unfortunately, the damn last guy could not even start his old wrecky car engine. After many attempts, he began moving, but was veering off the road and crashing here and there into walls, poles, and trash cans. He became frustrated and wanted to give up. What a pity. He began to cry and scream loudly, and suddenly an old man who could barely walk came to him and said, "Get up and move to the back seat. Let me drive you." He ignored the old man and continued to cry. Finally, he listened to the old man and got to the back seat of the car. Then all of a sudden, the old man turned to the opposite direction and went the other way. What? He became worried and cried louder because he knew the old man was going the wrong way. He knew he had lost completely, and he began to imagine how far his friends must have gone in the race of life. Soon, both men entered into the dark tunnel. It was a bad road filled with holes, mud, rocks, and grass. In fact, this was bad, and the ride was one hell of a drive. He became confused, angry, and began cursing his stars for giving this car to this old man. He continued complaining and nagging bitterly. This was the world's most traumatizing journey ever for him because the car was jerking, bumping, and knocking him from left to right. After a very long, tiring, and painful journey, they soon saw a bright light at the end of the tunnel, and the young man was excited to finally come out of the tunnel and this hell of a drive. It was not long and they reached the finish line, and he became excited to have been able to arrive finally. But he was sad because he knew his friends had already come ahead of him and he had missed all the fun. Then he asked the whereabouts of his friends. "Check out." And the old man said, "Look behind you. They are now coming." He was shocked and stunned to see his friends now racing towards the finish line, and he could not believe that he had actually won the race, and his friends could not even believe it too. Can you imagine? Then he asked the old man, "How come it was possible for him to win against all his friends who were ahead of him and better than him?" Check out the old man. Then the old man said, "Your friends had better chances than you, and they had greater opportunities, which made things easy for them, so they did not have to struggle. Hence, they took the easy route, which was comfortable and sweet, but the route was a long route. You had to go through the hard way, and it was the discomforting route, but that was the shortest way here, and you endured it. Secondly, if you had given up or being in a haste to end the race, you would have lost completely. Well done for holding on. You are the champ."
The analogy of the story or parable. One, the four friends are the different people you meet in life from different backgrounds with connections and better advantages than you. Two, the race represents a journey to success, greatness, or salvation. But some people are ahead from the start, and you might have nothing, nobody, or even a wrong start. 3. The old man represents the help from God. Therefore, the tunnel represents the trials and challenges you encounter when you accept the help from God through His Son Jesus.
Now the moral lessons. Never look down on yourself just because some people are better than you today. Never think hard times means you are never going to be successful. Don't give up no matter how difficult your situation may be. Don't always envy others and try to copy them. Your style may be the best. Story by Solomon Boche. Solo hits on the mic, motivational speaker and life coach. Check out the upcoming videos. Parable of the Lord, the Titanic versus the Noah's Ark. Trust me, it's coming soon and you don't want to miss. So subscribe to my YouTube channel, Solo Hits on the Mic. On the mic, on the mic, on the mic, on the mic, on the mic.